guys, what's up? Welcome back to my channel. This is Jigar over here and I welcome you to my channel. So today's video is going to be really, really interesting. So stay tuned with me because in this video, I am not going to share with you any tips. No single tip I am giving you in this video, as there are so many videos on tips and tricks on how to improve English. Rather, in this video, I am going to share with you my story that how I improved my English. And one more big revelation I am going to make in this video that I don't think that many of the people are knowing about me. And I think if you want to know English, if you want to gain your confidence, then you need to hear this. So please stay tuned with me till the end. So very first point is confidence. In speaking English, you need to have confidence. And I, being an average student everywhere, in school, in college, and as you guys know, I did my course from the Frankfin. This is not a first of all a sponsored video from Frankfin. So this is not a sponsored video from Frankfin. Neither I am supporting any of these institutes. I am just going to give you my example, my experience I am going to share with you. So yes, only listen and just take inspiration. If you can get something from me, I am damn sure you will get something or the other thing to learn from me. I am not doing my khud ki tarif, but you will get to know it, that why I am doing all this and why I am saying you that you should inspire from me, because those person who stammers have lack of confidence. Average person's confidence level is over here, but a person who stammers has confidence level over here. So for me, I am one of those person who stammers. Yes. So for me to have the normal person's confidence, plus I have to speak in English, I need to have this much of confidence level in me. But I didn't have that. So how did I get that? So first of all, thanks to Frankfin that they have this English module. Yes, English module. You can go any English class or you can just do practice at home also. I am not inviting you, or I am not drilling in your brain that you have to go to any English classes, or I'm not drilling in your mind that you have to go such institutes to improve your English. No, I'm just sharing you my experience, that what I did and how it by naturally I lifted up my confidence and how I am speaking right now. And to be very frank, I am not a very high level of stammerer. I didn't have that much of stammering problem in me, but the confidence which I was lacking, that led to me stammering, because I was always feeling conscious that whenever I will say anything, I will stammer. Whenever I will say anything, I will stammer. So the lack of confidence which degraded my confidence also in me. So the main is confidence, that once you have your confidence, you can speak English. But for me to gain my confidence was very important, because I was afraid of even speaking in English or in any other language apart from my Gujarati, because even I used to stammer in Gujarati. Yes, and how do I improve stammering? I clearly don't know, because as and when I grew up, my stammering just vanished. And right now, I only have 0.1% of stammering problem, which is very common and it can happen to any one of us. But when I was growing up, I had 10% of stammering problems. I used to break words, like I couldn't even used to speak a whole word properly. And from that background, I am to this fluent is all because of confidence that I knew that within me, I can speak properly. I can speak properly. I can speak like a normal person. All is because confidence. So I had that confidence as and when I grew up, and I was a little bit over here because of the speaking issues which I had and which I practiced in Frankfurt. So then it became to level that. Yeah. So now again, speaking about the confidence level, average person's confidence level is here, and then my gradually came up as in when my stammering problem got vanished, then it got to equal level of the normal person. Because most important thing that happened to me was the speaking modules, the speaking sessions which were held in Frankfin in the English module which they had. Listen to me carefully, because if you are a student in any of the institutes, always take part whenever teacher asks anything, or if you are given any chance to speak, just speak whatever you want to speak, just speak in front of the whole class, which will gradually raise your confidence. And that clearly happened to me. in a class batch, in a batch full of 25 people, they used to all speak normally. Listen to me, they used to speak all normally, like a normal human being. And I, being a conscious being, left aside, I used to never speak. How will I speak? I will stammer. But no, I had that confidence. Once, twice, I tried. I was scared, but then also I tried that, no, I have to speak, now or never. So whenever I used to get chance to speak in the class, I always used to raise my hand, at least give me a chance to speak, at least hear me, what am I going to speak. So I will be posting a picture over here of me making, and I think I was sharing a presentation to them. And I was the only one who was sharing, because that was like a presentation, and the teacher gave us a homework that tomorrow who will represent themselves and who will give the presentation in front of the whole class. So I wrote everything on the whiteboard, as you guys can see, and I literally explained each and everything to them in English. So yes, if you want to speak English, you have to start. Without even starting, you cannot improve your English. And to be very frank, I was not English speaker in the school also. Though I have studied in English medium, but that doesn't mean that I was speaking in English even every So even after studying in English medium, it was not like that I knew English and I'm something. I didn't have that attitude in me, because I studied from a normal English medium schooling, and in that teacher also used to speak in Gujarati and Hindi, and apart from English class, English period, no one used to speak in English, so we didn't have that practice to speak in English, to be very frank. And after that I did my graduation, then Frankfurt happened to me, where I actually got the whole atmosphere, the whole environment where I used to speak in English. The teacher used to speak in English to us, and we were also supposed to speak in English with them. So from this to this to this to this, your confidence gains, because as and when you start speaking, you know you are speaking right English, you are doing right, you are doing really well in your life, you are really doing well in speaking English. So you have to gain some confidence in yourself, and if you already have that much confidence, then please start talking in English to any of the class, or join any of the classes if you are capable. I am not telling you if you are not capable, then do fight with your parents and then go to the English classes. I am not talking about any of this. Just try to speak in English. If anything doesn't happen to you, then do one thing. Speak in front of the mirror. That is the best thing, because I had an environment in which I can speak in English, and as and when I speak, I used to gain the confidence. Yes, I can speak. So without even stammering, that's the main point. I was so happy in speaking English that I didn't used to stammer. Though I used to stammer sometimes in Hindi or in Gujarati, but in English, I never used to stammer. So that gained my confidence, and it is now this much higher too, and this is the normal person's confidence. I have immense confidence in myself that I can really speak well in English, and just speak in English. If you really want to speak in English, by speaking only you can improve your English. I'm not telling that from starting only you will be very, your English skills will be very powerful, your communication skills will be powerful. I'm not telling any of this to you. If you have that confidence, you will gradually gain it. And if you are speaking in front of the audience or in class, you will I am damn sure that your confidence will be multiplied by 100 times as and when you speak. So confidence is the must in yourself, that you can speak and leave away your shyness. That's a must, because if you want to speak but if you are shy, then your voice will not come out, and you will only left murmuring in your mouth, that your voice will not be cleared, your words will not be cleared. So it is very important that be bold, that yes, I can do it. I have that attitude in you, that yes, I can do it. I can do whatever I want to have. I can do. I can be whatever I want to be. It is all upon me, that how I want to build up my life, how I want to build up my personality. It is all upon you, that how you want to do it. It is all upon you. I don't know why this is sounding like an inspiration lecture or something or the other, but Yes, I just want you to feel confidence in yourself. That yes, I have shared with you what all I have experienced, how I gained the confidence to speak English, and to speak English is not a big thing. Let me be very frank to you, and even being myself, I tell this to myself that do not get overconfident upon your English skills, because English is just a language like Gujarati, Hindi, Sanskrit. English is just a language. If you know it, it doesn't mean that you are some superior person or you are a very wise person or you know everything. It is not like that. It is just a simple basic language, and you should not judge anyone upon their language. My fiance Harsh doesn't know English. Basic English is fine, but he doesn't know advanced English, or he cannot talk very fluent in English, but that doesn't mean that he is illiterate. He is much more wiser than me in many of the aspects in life. He makes me understand that how should I see some situations in my life. He guides me where I cannot even guide myself. He guides me. So please do not ever compare yourself with some other or some other to yourself, as you don't know how the situation is, or you don't know why you don't know English, or why this is again going in inspiration lecture. But trust me, because I have also gone through this phase in the classes only. I used to speak in English to everyone, and I know it was very bad from my side that I used to make them feel lower, that you don't know English, you are not that great, you are not that intelligent, and you are not that much smart or confident in yourself when you cannot speak English. So I came from that level that no, this is a very bad mindset, that you are judging people on basis of their English skills, which is very bad and which should not happen to you. I have gone up from that. I had raised myself from that. I have raised myself from that mindset that this should not happen to anyone, because in airline also, trust me, I have seen some crew who are really very nice personality, who have really pleasing personality, but they lack in English somehow, 19, 20, but they cannot speak English fluently, or they hesitate to speak in English fluently, but that doesn't mean that they does not deserve to be over here. So English is just a language. By God's grace, I'm really really thankful to him that I don't really stammer anymore. But yes, there were days that when I used to stammer and people used to make fun of me that what is she going to do in her life. Like, I have some of my classmates from school who thought that what will she do, she will just get married, or she will just she will not do anything in life because she stammers, she cannot speak properly even Gujarati, then what is she going to do in her life. But no, look at me, I'm earning more than them. I have much more respectable job. I'm not comparing any job, but I'm just saying that I am doing such a respectable job. I'm earning, I'm living by myself, I'm independent, and yes, I just made proud on myself. I just made myself proud that I made everyone wrong. I gave them a karara jawab by being a cabin crew, by proving myself to myself also first, and then to others that I can also do something in my life by my own, and which is by English. Because to crack interview, you have to speak in English, and by God's grace, I had that environment near me which helped me in gaining my confidence in speaking English. So confidence is the first key. I don't know whatever mistakes I did in this giving the lecture in English for like 17 minutes now, because it shows 70 minutes without even editing. So it doesn't matter to me that what grammatical mistakes I'm making or whatever I'm making mistakes in this speaking English, because I just want to show that you should have the confidence that whether it's wrong, no, it doesn't matter to me, as soon as I am going to improve myself on it. So this is the key, that you should know where you are going wrong and you should improve on it. This is the most, it's not like that, though I am speaking wrong, I'll speak wrong every time. No, it should not happen. You should always keep on improvising yourself every now and then, and to do that, always, always, always watch English series or English movies. But I have made improvement in the series and the movies that I can understand English series and movies without subtitles. I used to watch them with subtitles, but as and when I am hearing, I am watching this series and these movies from like years now, so I am habituated to hear those words repeatedly again and again, which helped me that I tried it. Like sometimes I used to switch off the subtitles and then you try to listen to it, that let's see how much I'm understanding to it, and if I'm mistakenly somewhere gone wrong and I don't understand this or that and I'm not getting what they are saying, then again I switch on the subtitles, I watch it, I read it, I understand it. So train your mind in every possible way that okay, this is not happening, let's try this, this is not happening, let's try this. So eventually you will be glad that how immensely your confidence has gained, how immensely your English has been improved. So yes, this is it from me guys. This is what I can share with you guys from my personal basis. I know there are many, like thousands and lakhs of videos on YouTube about how to improve your English, but they are just Google copy and pasted from from text to audio. There nothing else is in there, but in here the word to word I'm sharing with you is from my personal experience, which I have felt, I have experienced, and I have gone through from that. And you will not get this on Google or on other channels on YouTube, but you still can go and search on YouTube. You will get thousands of videos on it and you still can learn from it. I'm not denying they are wrong or I'm right. I'm just saying that each and every video is different. This video is different. This is me in this video. I'm sharing with you guys with my personal experience, which you will not get to see any other experiences. And yes, I know many of you wanted me to speak in Hindi, but let me tell you, I feel so much confidence in speaking in English that I will stumble, I will stammer, I will fumble, I will do everything in Hindi. I have to take so many retakes if I'm making a single video in Hindi. This is my 21 minutes I'm continuously speaking in English without even pausing or cutting this video. Just go with the flow, just speak whatever is in your mind or whatever you are thinking. Just speak it, but if it is in Hindi, I will stumble, I will pause, I will this, I will that. I will shoot one video in 2 hours. So, if you still want to make in, if you still want to So, if you still want to hear my videos, so if you still want me to make videos in Hindi, I will try to make it in English, but not properly Hindi. And you guys also want to learn English, so why not to make a practice over here only? To speak in English or to at least hear English. So yes, this is my time up now. I see you in my next video. Till then, bye bye and take care.